I'm going to talk about the impact of open source and with the focus of, on the economic value and how you can benefit and how you can look at it from a holistic picture in terms of the value it brings in to enhance the organization's operational model and improve the quality of software and those angles. So one of the obvious questions when asked about why use open source is that because it is going to cut down costs and because it is a so-called cheaper kind of scenario. But I think the reality with open source is that it just it is much more beyond just being cheap and just much more, there's a much more larger impact rather than just having a cost advantage. It is about quality. It's about how you think about software. It's about how you can learn from the models that software, open source software projects are run and implement some of those inspirational aspects into that one. And also being open source, it is more or less also means that more open standards are adhered and adapted to kind of scenario. And also being open source, it also means that various technologies are being incorporated into these products and then open source projects, and then all the state-of-the-art technologies are involved, and open source can be used to almost anything, to do almost anything that the enterprise needs, kind of scenario. So the reality is that it's not just about being free and open source, it is much more beyond that particular aspect. So when you talk about software, just having better software is not enough in order to achieve what you want in the industry. And if you run any software project, you will realize that you need much more beyond just being quality software. And that also means the process, the DNA, the attitude of the people, how they look at the world, how they interact with each other, etc. So coming back to open source, when you look at the software aspect of making sure what you can do in order to make sure that an IT project or a software project is successful in the enterprise, it's not just about the financial viability of being open source. It is also about the culture that open source brings into the organization. It's also about how you would think about collaborating with each other, how you can work as a community so that you can work with different parties that are involved with your software projects, and then the resulting quality aspects so that people are open about the mistakes they do, people are open about the gaps they find so that they collaborate with each other in order to fill those gaps and bring about better quality, better security, and then because of the open culture, because of the open discussion nature, the ideas get discussed in the open and more people have the opportunity to contribute with their ideas so that it naturally fosters innovation on how to do things better, et cetera, et cetera. So the value comes from the fact that the culture that brings comes along with the aspect of how open source software projects are run benefits both the users as well as the developers of the community. And also, when you are using open source, you get to get used to those cultural aspects, and then you can implement those cultural aspects in your organization, in your project as well. And then that would result in those benefits such as being open, being innovative, being secure, and being able to achieve high quality, etc. So open source model can be used as an engineering process. For example, like I said, collaboration is one of the things that you can adapt from the open source community aspects and how people discuss and contribute, etc. And then almost any technology area has a leading good open source software project, at least one or more in the space. And then there's this natural tendency to share the code, natural tendency to reuse the code. So that can also be incorporated into the engineering process. The feedback cycles are slashed so that because of the open communication and aggressive communication, you can get the idea shared so that that opens up the communication channels in order to give open and direct feedback in a quick manner, and then you can see whether those feedback can get incorporated sooner into the software that you develop. And then release often, release faster aspect, make sure that you can evolve faster in a rapid manner so that you can change directions if required and adapt to the change that is happening in the industry. And then the other aspect is obviously the quality aspect, because more people get to see what is going on, more people have the possibility of testing it if they want, and then they also have the possibility of giving feedback in an open manner when it comes to quality aspect, and especially when it comes to security aspects. So you have a lot of quality control happening via the community aspects of it, and all those aspects can be incorporated into the engineering process that you're trying to build software with, that you can learn from the open source communities. Then the other important aspect of open source is that the cultural models that you have in open source communities can be used in organizations to run the organization. For example, in WSO2, we develop open source middleware, but WSO2 is unique not only because of that, it is also unique in that we use the same culture inside the organization to run the organization, right? For example, every employee in WSO2 is on every mailing list. Like, even the interns are on strategy list. So they see what is being discussed in the strategy list, for example, and they can contribute if they have a better idea. They can learn from what is going on. So it is not only the marketing team who worries about marketing. Engineering team gets to contribute their ideas into the marketing team because it is an open channel for discussing marketing. Same happens with sales, same happens with engineering, same happens with support. So within employees, there's no secrets. Of course, there are sensitive things such as HR aspects, et cetera, that we don't discuss openly because we have to respect the people's privacy, et cetera. But by default, we are open. We close only those sensitive aspects of the organization where it is a must to respect sensitivity. So by default, being open helps people contribute, and also it breaks up the silos. For example, like it is not a marketing department where they just consider about their business and not communicate with the sales team or the engineering team. It's a collaborative effort that everybody can come and share their ideas in a space like marketing, in a space like sales, because once we engineer a product, the question of how you can market it, how you can inspire people about it, and how you can sell it to our customers, et cetera, comes into picture. And then it becomes a shared responsibility of everybody to be part of the system and make sure that success is achieved as an organization. And also, it helps with governance. It is distributed governance. And we reward people using the meritocracy model, where people who contribute and get to know more, get to do more, gets more respect, and they earn respect through what they do, kind of scenario. So the open source culture can be used as a successful organizational model to run an organization, and some of those values can be brought, leveraged to make sure that the organizations are much more agile and open and fit for business when it comes to running a business organization. So coming back to the software nature of open source and looking at some of the economic values that bring in, there are labor economics such as in open source communities, there are passionate people who put their cycles and implement things via the community and contribute it to the code base. So obviously that's an investment that they bring in to the project by investing cycles. And then obviously for users, there are direct cost savings because of the labor economics, et cetera. You can bring about a pricing advantage when it comes to pricing the solutions that you build on top of these products. And then because of the efficiency factor of the community-driven model, you can be efficient in terms of technically, strategically, socially, given when it comes to making decisions and moving forward in a faster manner, and making decisions in an effective manner. And then the other aspect of the open source model is that if you want to influence the products that you are going to use for your solutions, do you have an opportunity to make an impact on those products aspect is an important aspect when it comes to open source, because the fact is that you can participate in the communities, and then by participating in those communities, you can influence them to do the right thing. For example, if you have a better idea in terms of, okay, this feature is much more important in an enterprise level because we have these problems kind of scenario, and you can get into the community and influence the community to get the things that you want to do in a faster track manner in order to get the job done. So it's not about just cost, it is about strategic control that you have in order to make sure that the software project goes in the right direction in terms of the real business requirements that you have in the industry. So control, being able to influence and control over just focusing on cost is an important aspect that comes along the open source software space. And then the customer value is obviously the ease of adoption. The adoption becomes prohibitive if you have to invest a lot of cycles as well as a lot of money in order to make sure that whether it fits for you, whether it is good for you, etc. And also, if you have to figure out how can we be sure about what is happening with this product, how do we know what would happen in the future, etc. If they're problematic, it becomes difficult to convince that this is the right project to go with kind of scenario. So being transparent is an important aspect in open source software so that you have a clear understanding in terms of what is happening, because when you go for a software project, when you search Google and what is happening in user forums, what is happening in architecture forums, etc., you can get a good transparent grasp of what's going on with the project, and that helps you to understand whether your adoption of that particular project is going to help you in the long run kind of scenario, right? And then the other aspect is the legal aspect of it. Once you are going to adopt something into the organization, the legal department always have worries in terms of what would be the implications for us in the long run when it comes to controlling this, et cetera, et cetera. So open source licenses are well defined. There are no secrets about it. Once your product that you are going to use is under a particular license, it is very easy to go talk to the legal team and show that this one is under this license. What are the implications, and then the legal team is quite clear in terms of what the implications are. So it becomes an easier aspect when it comes to adopting, because there are no surprises associated with it, because it is public and it is well known and it is proven to work because so many people are using products under those licenses, etc., right? And then the cost effectiveness comes into play. It's a question about time and money. If you have enough time to invest, and if you have people, you can adopt open source, invest people, either get your people to contribute and get the job done. And if that's not the case, then most of the time around open source, there are support models, etc., where you invest money, go and get support for your open source projects and gets the job done. So on either way, whether irrespective of whether you have enough money to invest or if you don't have money but if you have time, you could invest and deliver some value. We are an open source software project. So you have both opportunities in there. So if you are starting small, if you don't have enough money to invest right now, still you can go with it. And then after some time, when you have more bandwidth and when you have proven track record of whether the software is working for you or not, then you can go to the management and investors who has the money and get it invested in there and then maybe later get support, et cetera. So that particular advantage is always there with open source option because since it is open source and since it is under a proven license, there are no legal implications. You can use it in either model. And then given any software IT solutions project, the ABCs are hardware, software, and services, right? And then as you know, hardware costs are quite stable. There's nothing much you can play around with. If you want to change the economic aspects in a project, what you can play around with is the cost that you invest for software and the cost that you invest on the services associated with that particular project. So if you have a particular project where you have to, you have a particular constant amount of money that you always allocate for hardware, your variable factors are where can you cut down in order to save money? Can you save money from, by cutting costs for your software, or can you save money by cutting costs for services? And then the obvious choice would be to cut costs in the space of software, because then either you can save money in the service, for the whole project and show a cost advantage, or you can reduce the cost for software and then go for higher quality services, et cetera, and make sure that your overall IT solution is faster delivered or better with better quality delivered. So that your stakeholders are always happier with your delivery. So by going open source, you get more control over being able to control the costs of software. So either you can save on the overall budget, or you can make the decision of, okay, the money that I'm going to save, I'm going to reinvest into services and make sure that the IT project is more predictable, more quality services are bought, et cetera. So you can decide by using open source software how you want to move forward and control the overall cost for the IT solution that you are going to implement using open source software. And you have more flexibility now to play with more variables and decide where the project should move and how the project should move. And then the other aspect when it comes to the open source arena is that if you are talking about the middleware space, et cetera, and if you have a platform-oriented nature of a middleware aspect such as WSO2, you can think about plug and play so that some part of the solution could be proprietary or existing systems, and you can choose some of those components in the overall solution that you want to implement be replaced or be used with some open source models, and then try and figure out what fits better, what doesn't fit better, so that you can always decide what are you going to use under this overall solution, what components will be from proprietary providers because they you want that particular solution from that particular vendor versus what you can use from the open source arena, or whether you can, you want to use the whole stack from open source aspects kind of scenario. So the plug and play ability is an important aspect that comes along, and then you also have the option of trying it out for free and see whether it would work for you in the open source arena, and if not, then you can later decide to throw it away and go with some other solution or other alternative software vendor if you want to, other alternative software, open source software component that better fits you so that you can plug and play the overall solution the way you want kind of scenario. And the other aspect is that the learning time, the training costs goes down with open source, obviously. If you really participate in the open source community, one of the key advantages is that you can find free help from the community. There should be blogs, there should be Stack Overflow entries, there should be articles, etc. And obviously, the documentation should be available, and if not, documentation is not good enough. Because of the open source nature, multiple people can have the possibility of contributing, and then you will always be able to find material. And obviously, the other aspect is that you can download it for free, play with it for free, explore and try it out for free. And if it works, it works. If it doesn't work, you can seek for help. And if you want to walk the extra mile, and if you have the capacity to fix, and if you have time to fix, you can get it fixed and contribute back as well. So all those possibilities are available with the open source options that you have, and then you don't have to spend money per se in order to start it, with the model. And then the other aspect is that the trial and error aspect is quite open. You can give it a free try and see if it works and decide whether you want to move forward or not. And you are not going to lose anything because you don't have to invest anything at upfront with open source. Then the other aspect is that if you go with open source model for your internal projects, etc., you can become part of the community, and also you can drive your IT project also in the same fashion and make sure that other people in your organization can contribute to the same, and then you can also demonstrate that the value is there, they can participate in this, and they can collaborate with the solutions that you're trying to implement in the organization. And one of the other things that WSO2 also uses heavily is the aspect of being able to extract talent, because when your projects that you are involved with are open source, the reality is that other people have the opportunities to participate, and if they already have some experience with those elements from other areas that they already participated in, it becomes a good opportunity for you to acquire talent into the organization when it comes to looking for people to help implement solutions that you have. And then in terms, I spoke a little bit about influence. In terms of influencing what is happening with the project, there are multiple dimensions that you can work with. You as a user can have the ability to influence. You have the ability to ask questions, respond to questions that are being asked. You as a user can write documentation or write blogs, and also you as a user can provide feedback to the community, etc. So that's a way of contributing as well as a way of influencing, because you as a user have the capacity to give open feedback to the community. Then comes the next level of contribution, where you have the cycles to help fix things, you have the cycles to participate in the community so that you provide your ideas, you provide your fixes, etc. And then over time, if you do enough of that, you have the opportunity of becoming a committer. And once you are a committer, now you are an author of the project, now you have direct influencing power on the project, and then apart from being the influential in the community, you also have the aspect of visibility so that people will respect you for who you are in the community. And that helps you to be in control. So business organizations could go along that path and make sure that you have people who are committers of the project so that you have some form of influence on the project when it comes to discussing matters, etc., in the space. And the other aspect is the branding value that open source has. When you go in front of your manager or some decision maker, and when you say, okay, this is open source, it has the same brand influence, and it becomes a selling point, an easy to sell point, because open source is well understood in the industry, and then people are comfortable with dealing with open source related projects. And that is because of this particular factor. It's open source is no longer something that you have to go and influence. If you look at some of the major industries, it is becoming the default. People prefer it. People give it the first preference when it comes to choosing solutions, etc. So it's no longer an effort to prove, go and prove that open source is the right thing to do. It's the default. So you don't have a problem when it comes to making sure what's going on. And then it would be interesting to know what some of the customers, et cetera, are doing in these spaces when it comes to open source. So what they're doing is that they make open source the default so that if you want to start a new project, you give the mandate to employees saying that you should first look for open source based solutions in order to try and solve this particular problem. And then you also define a transition strategy so that you have this level of solutions implemented right now. For new stuff, you will go by default into open source, but in the, as you move along, what is your strategy to replace existing systems with open source equivalents kind of scenario? And then customers are also trying to be collaborative with open source communities so that it helps them to, again, help get what they want to do with the product so that they are more comfortable in terms of the future roadmap, et cetera, that is going to go with the product, et cetera. So I hope I tried to influence you in terms of what are some of the business values and what are some of the possibilities that comes along when it comes to economically and financially benefiting from open source, just beyond the financial factors, how you can participate in the community experience.